Hi, my name is Dr. Sarah Bjorkman, and I am a board-certified OBGYN and also a reproductive endocrinology and infertility specialist. You may have followed us through our last pregnancy and postpartum and all of the things. And now, as we are trying for baby number two, found ourselves unable to get pregnant and are now doing IVF. So the IVF doctor has now become the patient, and I thought it would be helpful to go through IVF medications, how to give them, how to draw them up, and so come along with me as I give myself my meds tonight. The next injection we are going to demo and talk about is probably the least favorite of all IVF medication injections, and that is progesterone in oil. This one is pretty unfun, and you may have to do it, if things go well, for many days to weeks. So let's talk about this really quickly. So progesterone, if you had a fresh transfer, if you're doing a fresh transfer, basically we just sucked your ovaries dry, so they don't work exactly like we expect. So we need to give you progesterone back to help develop that endometrial lining so it's nice and receptive and ready for that embryo to implant. Same kind of concept in a frozen embryo transfer to get ready for a frozen transfer. We are kind of taking over that whole cycle, getting your lining ready for an embryo transfer. So again, we have to give progesterone back, usually for 5 days before your transfer, to get that endometrial lining nice and ready for embryo. So progesterone is a pretty thick liquid, which makes it a little slower to inject. So you're gonna get a vial, and you're gonna use this vial for multiple days. So the dosage is 500 milligrams per 10 mLs or 50 milligrams per ml. And there are 10 mLs in each vial, so that's 10 doses per vial. This can be stored at room temp until its expiration date. Some things that you may have seen on TikTok. A lot of people, at least, you know, on TikTok, tips for making this better. They'll like put this in their armpit to warm it up, or they'll roll it in their hands to warm it up. Our pharmacist said, don't do that, because then you are warming this liquid every single time, and that isn't great for it. If you want to pull up your single injection and then roll that syringe itself in between your hands, fine. Don't put your multi-dose vial in your armpit. You can ice your hip again to make this less painful, because progesterone in oil is again an intramuscular injection. So it's a longer needle. We need to get it all the way into the muscle. And we're doing that again in the ventrogluteal injection site. It's kind of on your hip. You can ice before if that helps, get it in a little numb. There's different shot blocker things you can use to kind of distract. When you inject, again, you're going to put the needle all the way in, draw back a tiny little bit, and then inject all the way till all that liquid is gone. 1, 2, 3, pull out. The progesterone in oil can be a little bit itchy, so if there's a little bit of that on your skin, you're gonna wanna make sure that you wash it off. The number one side effect of this is sore hips. Like, your glute really gets sore to numb after a while. So what our pharmacist recommends is a 3 to 5 minute massage right after you do the injection to really help get that into the muscle. And then she, you know, recommends you move, have whoever's giving you that shot, move all the way up to your neck, do a nice full body massage. Not necessary, but recommended.
Doesn't help with the medication, but.
No, it does not.
Massages are always good.
But think of that as you're injecting kind of this glob of thick liquid into your muscle. Think of it like a glob of jelly. You want to massage it around into that muscle so it really gets spread out. Afterwards, you want to move that leg, do a little bit of hip, glute, leg exercises, jazzercise, walk, hula hoop, anything just to get it into that muscle to help with soreness. Then afterwards, ice, heat, whatever feels better for you. We usually do a rice sock, heat it up in the microwave and hold it there, sit on it on my hip, and that's been helpful. I would recommend, pro tips, alternating right hip, left hip, right hip, just to kind of take it easy and not continually beat up one hip right after the other. That being said, sometimes one hip will get more sore than the other, and it is okay to do two in a row on the same hip, or three in a row if you've got a really sore hip. Other final notes with progesterone. Progesterone in oil is not one of those injections that is critically important that you give it at exactly the same time every night like it is with those gonadotropins and some of the other medications we talked about. It is a great idea to give it at the same time every night, set an alarm, do whatever you need to have a routine of giving it at the same time. But this is more a plus or minus 4 hour window and you would still be okay, all right? So progesterone, you are going to start 5 days before your embryo transfer. You then continue that progesterone until your pregnancy test, which is usually 9 to 10 days after transfer. So I always tell patients that is 15 days of an injection that kind of sucks, where you don't know if you're pregnant or not. If you are not pregnant, you will be able to stop this injection. And if you are pregnant, then you have to continue, which again sucks, but you're doing it for a very important reason to support that early pregnancy. And it becomes just a little more worth it when you know, hey, I'm suffering with a purpose now.
And you're continuing that for how long?
It depends on your protocol for your clinic. It very much varies. Some people supplement with vaginal progesterone as well. Some do it every third day, some do it every day. Some do it up to 8 weeks, some to 10, some to 12. So again, that is going to be very protocol dependent. So make sure you know your end date with your progesterone, which I sure already am counting down to being able to stop this. So, shall we?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, so Kurt's gonna get everything ready. And we'll talk them through what we're gonna do. So the first thing we're doing here is when you open your progesterone, there is a little cap that flicks off, and now you want to sterilize the top of this rubber stopper every time you do it. You are going to open your syringe, and some, you may get a syringe that has a needle on it, your drawing needle. You may have to put your drawing needle on it. It's usually a thicker and shorter needle, so this draws up faster. You also want to get your injection needle ready, which again is just longer, 1.5 inch needle instead of the shorter drawing needle.
So, drawing needle, sometimes it's nice to push just a little bit of air in, makes it a little easier to draw it back out.
Again, the dose is 50 milligrams per milliliter. So if you need a 50 milligram injection, you need 1 ml. If you're doing 75, you would need 1.5 ml of the liquid. Again, this, you gotta tip it upside down and take your time drawing back because it's a thick liquid that takes a little bit.
And so as you're drawing this, you'll notice this draws up a lot more slowly than the other medications just because it's so thick in that oil. So just give it a little time. And if you get more than you need, you can always give it back to the vial. Okay. And we're going to change our needle, right?
Yep.
Removing the drawing needle and changing out for the injecting needle. Okay, now what's next?
The fun part. The not fun part. So in terms of location on your hip, my clinic tends to draw a big purple circle that you can keep marked on your hips that I usually keep retracing. Sometimes it washes off and your nurses in your clinic are going to be happy to redraw that for you, or you can just, you know, look at a picture of what the ventrogluteal spot is and get very good at hitting that. You can also, after a while, just see where you injected last and go in that general area. So, alcohol swab.
Okay, I can feel where hip is. I know where I'm going here. Cleaning again is kind of over that hip bone, kind of in the kind of front half of that hip.
But you don't want to hit the bone.
Not hitting the bone, exactly. So again, sterilizing the spot. Just wanting to make sure it's a clean injection site.
Three circles is one.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay. Good.
Oh, now, I can't wait.
What kind of things do I need to think about while I'm doing this?
You're going to inject. You're going to pull back to make sure that you don't get any blood return. And then you just slowly push.
Okay.
Till it's gone. Hold two, three.
Good.
Oh, I can't wait.
Hey, poke. Okay, man. No blood return, drawing back. And then slowly pushing. I'm all the way in with this needle into the muscle.
Tingly.
Okay. And out. Tapping the needle. And then massaging that oil in.
Let's go. Yeah. So that was a progesterone injection. And that was kind of wraps up our little med teaching video. Again, some of the meds you take may vary based on your protocol and what your clinic uses. The one resource I want to share with all of you is a website called freedommedteach.com. It is an amazing, amazing resource that has instructional videos for every single IVF med, from drawing up, switching needles, getting ready. I mean, absolutely everything based on the IVF med. So we will link that here. I mean, just everything alphabetically, cetrotide, estradiol, valerate, folistim, ganirelix, general IM injections, general sub-Q injections, gonal-F, luprolide, luprolide trigger, menopur, novorel, literally every IVF med you might need is at this website with great step-by-step videos to help you if you are find yourself about to do that injection and you're like, oh, I don't remember what they showed me at clinic. I really want someone to walk me through this again. freedommedteach.com is an awesome, awesome website. So that is all we have.
Make sure you subscribe, guys, and we will see you in the weeks to come. We're doctors.
But not your doctors.
Anything we've said in this video is for education or entertainment purposes only.
It is not medical advice.
Any specific medical questions you have should be directed to your provider.